Hey everyone, Nick from Coleman's Music here, and this is the B&G Guitar's little sister, all the way from Tel Aviv in Israel. This is one of the more quirky guitars that we have in the shop at the moment. Obviously, it's sort of like a Gibson Nighthawk shape, but you've got that slotted headstock and the classical style tuners, a soft V-neck. This thing is really quite different. And maybe is the thing that you're looking for, the missing color in your tonal palette. It's a beautiful thing. There's lots of strange, quirky little details about this guitar that I'm going to go through now. This is the little sister. So this beautiful handmade guitar features an African mahogany chambered body. It's been carved out. You've still got a solid center block. But you've got lots of resonant chambers carved into that back piece of mahogany there. The top on this one is quite interesting. This is Cedar of Lebanon. Obviously, cedar is quite a soft wood for the soundboard of a guitar, more commonly found on acoustic instruments. But they've chucked it on here, and I can't wait to hear how that sounds. Hopefully, you can hear that intricacy in the video. Obviously, you've got two classic F holes giving it that old school feel, and a Florentine style cutaway, meaning that you can get super high for all your shredding needs. The neck on this thing is genuine mahogany with a Catalox fretboard, which is something that I'm unfamiliar with, so any wood experts, please chime in the comment section as well. The neck on this has this soft V feel to it, which is really cool. It feels like an old Gibson parlor guitar or something like that. It's got this this nice classic kind of feel and thickness to it. It's a 24¾ scale length neck with a 12 inch radius. It's got 20 nickel frets, a tusk nut, and yes, a slotted headstock. How cool. This guitar features B&G Delta tuners, which are vintage style classical guitar-esque tuners. Obviously because of that slotted headstock. Really cool for stage diving with, because they're less likely to get knocked by punters in the crowd. How good? You've got a solid brass ABR1 style bridge with six intonatable saddles there. And you also have a solid brass little sister trapeze style tailpiece. They say that this also adds to the acoustic qualities of the guitar. But once again, let me know if you can hear it. You also have gold-plated brass pickup covers on these hand-wound B&G P90 pickups, which is something that's obviously also unique to this guitar. It really adds to that kind of vintage aesthetic that they're going for with this instrument. I wonder if it does anything to the sound. Can't wait to try this thing out. Also under the hood, you've got CTS pots, a switchcraft jack, and it's 50s style wiring with volume, and a master tone. So yeah, that's pretty cool too. I'm going to plug this thing in now and have a bit of a play of it, and we can finally hear what the little sister sounds like. Does she sing? Who knows? We'll find out now. Also, before I do that, it also comes with this lovely hard case. So your little sister will be safe from the cruel, cruel world.